mean, even like 10 cups of coffee will not help you keep pace with Disney's fastest hero, who could outrun a cheetah, peregrine falcon, you name it. Woo! Jeez, so this hero makes Usain Bolt look like a tortoise. I mean, hey guys, Harry Thomas here, and you all know I never miss a DC trailer. So yesterday, when the Super Bowl trailer for The Flash, which is the first proper trailer for the movie since summer last year, dropped, you know I was going to react faster to it than The Flash could sprint, and I am 100% with all the praise this trailer has received. This is the greatest trailer of 2023 thus far. I mean, absolute masterpiece. Even the brand new poster with Barry in Michael Keaton's Batcave, I mean, looks badass as a fucker. But I am oh so happy to hear that the fans are, looks like they're putting, their thoughts on Ezra Miller as a person in the past and are gonna judge the movie as it is. Do not feel guilty, because don't worry, you are not, defending Ezra Miller's crimes or behavior. You are just seeing a fabulous movie, which is exactly what it looks. And heck, James Gunn even praised it as one of the greatest superhero movies of all time. If they didn't think so, they would have cancelled it entirely. And I trust James Gunn on this. And this trailer, not only do we get double Barry Allen, so future Barry Allen interacting with past Barry Allen. And I mean, so Ezra needed to play two versions of himself. I mean, that is super creative effects already. And this looks like a super emotional a story for Barry. You know, he's doing this to save his mother. Who wouldn't, to save their mother? And plus multiverse, the DC version of it, I mean, just looks freaking epic. I mean, we get General Zod and his Kryptonian army, and we go back to the Battle of Metropolis in Man of Steel. So did Barry Allen change that's a point in history right there? And then one golden moment in the trailer when Michael Keaton flawlessly steps back into the role of Batman, like he only played him yesterday. There's a long pause before he says the line, "Yes, I'm Batman." We're going to get well, it not just Michael Keaton as a Batman, but also Ben Affleck's Batman. So Batflick is returning. I am in Batman heaven from this trailer alone, and in the movie it should be even more satisfying. And those who douses Michael Keaton and predicted he would be overaged to return as Batman, you needn't worry, because he looks as active as ever. And of course, the show stealer of this entire trailer is Kara El, aka Supergirl. I mean, I wouldn't have minded if Melissa Benoist from the TV show played her in this movie, but this actress, I mean, she looks like she's got it.
Try not to die.
It's not Clark.
My name is Kara.
I'm Barry. We're Barry.
Sasha Keola, no doubt you are going to be super as a Supergirl. And doesn't she look similar to Kamala Khan from Miss Marvel? So yeah, this trailer was 100% perfect. I mean, and it's got me triple as hyped as I was before, and it looks like this movie is gonna receive a ton of love when it releases this June instead of hate. Phew! It's also by a landslide my favourite trailer from this year's Superbowl. All the others, Indiana Jones and the Dial of Disaster, made me cringe. Transformers Rise of the Beasts, fine. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, funny as hell. So yeah, and we may have to wait a couple of months for The Flash, but in just 1 month, for my review of Shazam 2 Fury of the Gods will come. Woohoo! Woo! Well, I love you guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this trailer as much as I did. And what are your thoughts on the trailer? I mean, I can guarantee a nearly universally positive response, judging by the reactions. Please comment and let me know. Please like this video and subscribe. Please follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And I'll see you next time when more reviews are coming your way. A rant on Teen Wolf, the movie, as well as reviews of Puss in Boots 2, The Last Wish, and Ant-Man and the Wasp 3, Quantumania, as well as continuing my Quarry playthrough. And remember, movies are us. Bye, guys.